Hi guys, I'm Shirley. I work in a precision plastic injection tool company in Dongguan City, Guangdong Province, China. It only takes about 20 to 40 minutes to go to Shenzhen and Hong Kong by high-speed rail. Very convenient. I know people from all over the world are focusing on coronavirus outbreak in China recently. Many of my customers send their best regards to me. I'm deeply moved and I'm very much appreciated to my customers and anyone who supports us and helps us in this special time. Of course, you are included. Well, some of my customers showed their worry about this virus. For example, should we be worried about my projects in China? Will this virus infect my tools, plastic moldings, products, etc.? Well, I'll give you the answer later, but first of all, I'd like to introduce you the 10 main procedures of plastic injection tool making. Let's watch this. We'll be right back. about the 10 main processes of plastic injection tool manufacturing. Of course, there are more machining processes such as mini machining, grinding machining, drilling, and so on. And I will take more tool machining process videos in my following weeks. So please don't forget to subscribe me, smash the like button, open the small bell, and leave your comments below. Let's go back to coronavirus. Will this virus infect your tools, molds, plastic projects in China? Are you safe to receive packages from China? Well, let's hear what the experts say from the World Health Organization.
There's some people asking whether receiving packages from Wuhan or China would put them at risk in any way.
Yeah, so have we seen that question a lot? No, I mean, you're not at risk of this virus from receiving a package. Sometimes we look at viruses and how long they can survive on a surface, for example. Mm-hmm. And they don't survive very long. So if you're receiving something from overseas from China, you're not at risk of this of contracting this disease.
Okay.
As you just heard from the expert, so please don't worry. You're pretty safe to receive packages, tools, or products from China. I have more to say that your tools and projects are safe in China. First, our last working day was on January 20th. In other words, we closed down before the coronavirus outbreak. Second, we planned to go back to work on February 3rd, but in order to further control the virus, we have been told to extend our holiday till February 17th. So during this home period, nobody touched your projects. Third, after we go back to work, we will be demanded by our government to wear masks, check temperature, do disinfection work every day until the virus gone. Fourth, if your tools or products need to be shipped as soon as we get back, we can disinfect them to be sure everything's okay before shipping. Fifth, workers from Hubei province, the academic area, or anyone who has been to Hubei will be isolated for 14 days before working. Sixth, every checkpoint, including bus station, railway station, airport, highway, will have staff to check people's temperature and ID when we go back to work. It's really a hard time for every Chinese at present. But our government have taken many powerful and the most strict measures to stop the virus spreading, such as everybody must stay at home during this spring festival. We are not allowed to visit our relatives. In my village, anyone who has been to Wuhan, our local doctors are checking their temperature every single day once or twice. Anyone who gets fever will be isolated immediately and sent to the hospital for further checking. Roads among villagers have been locked down. Masks are required when we have to go out. As you may know, Wuhan have built two hospitals specially for coronavirus treatment in 1 week. In 1 week? Amazing, right? I'm proud of it. More than that, all confirmed cases got free treatment. People from all over the country donated money and medical supplies. Also, many overseas countries sent their helping hand to us. We are very much appreciated. Now I have a question for all of you. Look at this picture. There are two different parts. One is black part, the other is a white part. They were both in one cavity and H13 steel, but the sizes of the white part are 4 times bigger than the black part. So, which tool do you think is more bigger and more expensive? Leave your comments below and I'll tell you the answer in my next video. Once again, subscribe now, smash the like button, and open the small bell. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week. Take care.